What's up, y'all? Arleason85 here. Got a Domination Game Battles match. It's a 1v1 singles match. Rules are a little bit different than regular Game Battles matches. The time limit is only 5 minutes per side compared to 8 minutes. And the respawn delay is set at 5 seconds respawn delay. That was very, very unlucky. To get 99% done on capturing a flag and then you die. Like, that's the thing, like, I've played a few singles dominations now, but this was my first one, and, like, sometimes they'll rush right to B and try and get you off your spawn, and then sometimes they'll just cap their home flag. You know, you gotta be able to predict. That's all, singles is all about predicting, and you don't want to over-predict. Like, that guy, he was assuming that I was gonna try and come back to the flag, so instead he waited for me to come back. I got a stun hit marker, so I'm assuming he's taking it, which ends up getting me killed, and now he's able to take C and B. So right here, I get another stun hit marker, so I know he's over this way somewhere, but I lose track of him. In my mind, I'm thinking, the guy has two flags, he's got to be around here somewhere waiting for me to hop on, so I'm looking, I'm like, there's only 5 minutes, it's already a minute and 20 seconds in, and I haven't even gotten a single point yet. And I'm like, I gotta hop on. Right now, I'm triple capped. I'm like, wow, I'm getting owned right now. You know? And this guy, like, I don't know if I said it or not, but I think he was 7-0, or I can't remember exactly. This was a while ago. But he wasn't bad. I think he's like a 19K or something like that. Those who play game battles that... we know what I'm talking about. That's like his rank. Like, my rank right now is like a 40K, I think, or 48K. And yeah, this guy was a 19K, and he was actually really good. But yeah, look, right there, you can see him. He's probably has the back button, well, select button up, waiting for the dog. I guess not dog tags in this game. What's it called? The purple heart to disappear. That will tell him when I respawn. And he's sitting there cooking a stun grenade waiting for me to respawn. But since he had most of the flags, he wasn't sure where I was going to respawn, I guess, because he was looking the incorrect way. Right now he's about to triple cap me again. I'm just like, man. Like, I don't really play singles. Singles can be very aggravating. Especially, I don't know. It's just, it can be very aggravating one-on-one. It's like, no matter what happens, if you lose, it's your fault. And I mean, I only play it when I'm bored. That's the only time I play it. Or if I'm like none of my team is on, I can't do doubles, I can't do override, I can't do team or nothing, and I just want to, or you know, get some easy XP, stuff like that. That's really the only reason I play singles. It's not really for me, I don't think. But yeah. Secure. Able to get two flags back here. He's already capping beef. It looked like I was trying to run through Villa for some reason. I don't know if I knew he was capping it or not, but I able to get the headshot here. I'm just spraying. Thank God for extended mags, because that was horrible accuracy. He just stayed at the flag, if you notice that, because I captured A maybe 5 seconds before he captured B, so he was assuming that I was watching him to run off the flag, but that was smart for him to stay there, so I went ahead and did it myself. I stayed right on B, right after I captured it. Bam, get the kill. That's a good tip. Like, as soon as you cap a flag, try not to run too far away from it, because like I said, in singles there's only 5 second respawn delay, and it takes 10 seconds to cap that flag. So you gotta, even if you get the kill while you're on the flag, there's always gonna be that 5 second point from when he respawns to when you finish capping the flag. Like, any nade could be tossed, he could see you running off away from capping the flag, so your best bet is just to stick close. Yeah. Right here, I get a pretty nice nade. Yeah, that was a nice nade. That was able to save him from capping C and give me a chance to cap B. See, he's right there. He just spawned up, and I still haven't even capped the flag yet. Right now, I'm holding a triple cap. The score is 56-82. So I'm still losing because I didn't even get... Hold on. I didn't even get a single point for a while at the beginning of the game. But yeah, I come back with a triple cap, which ends up making a huge difference. Because 65 to 82, that triple cap for that last, what was it, 30 seconds or so makes a huge difference. But I'm down, I don't know, I'm shitty at math. Was that like 16 points? 26 points, somewhere in there. And we go right into the second half, and I spawn at the A spawn now, which is the better spawn. I can't even remember what happened. This game was played so long ago. Probably should have cut this part out, I guess. The waiting. I got so many matches that I want to upload. Like, let me go ahead and look real quick. I got so much stuff that I need to upload still. I got
securing alpha.
Like 3 2v2s, a whole bunch of 3v3 MLG domination matches, some map gen search, some 4v4 search, some clutch videos, like a 1v2, a 1v3, a flawless game battle search. I played some Modern Warfare 2 the other day and I caught some boosters, so I got some booster busting videos. Some Call of Duty 4 game battles match, or actually, it was search overrides from Call of Duty 4. Some doubles, some capture the flag doubles, some zombie gameplay for the new map. I got the round 31 just messing around. Like, I got a bunch of stuff I need to upload. And as you see right there, he capped his home flag this time instead of rushing to B. Like, I remember at the beginning of the match, I was like, he's going to rush B again, isn't he? And I was like, you know what, he may try to switch it up thinking that I'm going to rush B because he did the last time. Like I said, it's all about predicting and not want to over-predict, but you need to be able to predict where he's going to go and what he's going to do. And that's going to get you the win most of the time. Like, it's more about playing games with the person rather than gun skill. Like, if you're good at juking out people and psyching them out, especially with only 5 minutes to play domination, it's all about the points at the beginning. Whoever's smart enough to get the 2-cap at the beginning and hold it for a decent amount of time, let's say like 2 minutes, you're pretty much golden. I mean, 5 minutes is not a long time to come back. As you've seen, I had a triple cap for a decent amount of time and I still wasn't able to come back. Now right here was what I was talking about. See, he capped it and laid there. He just waited for me. Now, he obviously still died because he didn't know which way I was coming from, but if he was to run off, he didn't even have a chance to kill me at all. Rather than just laying there, he at least had a chance from getting me from coming from one direction. Now right here, I just lay as well, and I took his own trick, and it worked in my favor. I was laying to his spawn, but I knew he was going to be spawning and probably running that way. And even if he came up behind me, I was behind the planter, so more than likely wouldn't have seen me.
Losing Bravo.
So right now, I can't really see it. Looks like 45 to 32. That's a nice nade spot right there. It works almost every time. Later on in this match, you'll see it. That's the spawn right over there, right where I threw those stuns, where he spawned. If you're in that spawn, then they will spawn, I believe, right where the beach pillars are, like the little building right that connects to the beach. This nade's kind of hard to hit from top villa to B. That nade is kind of hard to hit. But yeah. Get a nice little kill there. I don't even remember why he didn't get that flag. I think he was on it and then he just ended up hopping off of it trying to dodge the nade, but he didn't get back on in time to recap the flag. And then I get the kill off the respawn, able to hop on for a triple cap because, like I said, I was down, I don't know, I think it was like 16 points or so, like 60-something to 80-something. So I need to be able to get as much points as I can. We're winding down to the last minute here, so yeah, I just need to get as much points as I can. He gets B, he's still laying there, like, I'm sitting here waiting for him to run off. He decides to run off and go for A because he knows he needs to get a flag now. He's down 40 points now.
Victory is near,
82-46, right about 38 points or so. I know he spawned up. He's going to probably try and nade me. Yeah, I end up dying right there. One thing I would suggest for singles is if you want to play singles, I would suggest maybe... I don't know. I'm not really a radar person, but a lot of people play radar. I don't like radar. I think domination takes the most skill out of all the game modes for singles.
But
I would choose to use assault rifles only, just to avoid people who use rapid fire and steady aim, just because that can be really annoying. And perks wise, if you're going to play domination, first perk off the start for the first rush, if you're going to try and go for the B flag, I would suggest lightweight. But otherwise, scavenger is the way to go. So you could, every time you kill the person, run over his dead body and get a new name. But yeah, right here, I end up winning. The total of the both scores together, I end up winning. I remember he was sitting there kind of mad. He was like, wow, that's the first time I've lost a map yet. So I was like pretty proud. I ended up coming back off of a triple cap in the first half. But yeah, guys, I'll bring you the next half soon as I can commentate it. And thanks for watching.